What's up guys, this is Hal Hart back with another video. Before we get started, make sure you like and subscribe for more video content. In this video, we're continuing with the rendering topics, the rendering types. Before I get to the rendering type that I want to talk about though, I need to show you one more thing about the multicolor bands that will be very useful if you're bringing in single band or really any other type of raster data. So right now I have a piece of raster data here that is a single band. It's a single band gray piece of raster data. You can see that because the only colors that you see are white and black. Let's go ahead and open up the properties here. And we see that it has a single band gray setting, which is the rendering type we'll be talking about in just a moment. But let's go ahead and flip it over into the multi-band color. In the multi-band color, what we'll see is the single band gets transitioned or gets re-rendered into another band type or another render type. In this type, remember we talked about it gives you three bands: red band, green band, blue band. What I wanted to show you though before I go into the other one is when you have a red band like this, or you have your single band in the red band, and let me click apply here. If I click apply, you'll see that my nice red or my nice white and black raster file is now red. It is being displayed inside the red band. If I would like to display it in the green band, I would say I'll set this to not set. I would set my green band to that single band layer. All I would need to do is type in 0 here to cover the bottom range, and then the max is this, which I'll copy and paste down here. I can hit apply on that, and I'll get a nice green overlay. Let's go ahead and go not set and set it in the blue band. Same thing, 0, and then paste that, hit apply, and there is our blue band. So you can actually mix this up however that you see fit, okay? And if you set all of them, I believe it goes back to normal if you set all of them the same way. Let me hit that. That's purple. That's blue and red together makes purple. I forgot what green and red makes. Let me see. Green and red. Green band. Let's hit apply there. Okay, yellow. So green and red makes yellow. So you can kind of play with these bands here in the multicolored band if you have some type of raster data like this. And you can change the color of it however you see fit. But anyway, back to the actual rendering type that I'm going to be talking about, which is the single gray band here. We'll hit apply, turn it back to the regular color. This is the simplest render type that I'll be talking about. I've already covered the color rendering, the resampling, and all of that. What we'll focus on is right up here. So in the single band gray render type, it's going to give you a few basic options. First, you can pick the single band that you're working with, and you can do this if you have a multi-band raster or whatever raster that you bring in. You can switch it to single band gray and have these same effects. Anyway, it's also going to give you a color gradient, okay, in the black to white gradient. Now in this section you have two choices. You have the black to white, or you can do the white to black. Now what does that mean? It means that your spectrum from 0, which are your darker colors, to the max, which is 1 on this raster data, 0 to 1 because it only has two default colors, which is white and black. But the spectrum is going to run from the 0 mark, which will be black, to the maximum, which is white. You can also switch this over and go from white to black. Now I'm going to show you another piece of raster data so this can be more noticeable, but I'll go ahead and flip this. All it's going to do is inverse this piece of raster data. So I hit apply, it inverses my Africa cropland. So the dark areas that you saw before were heavily there's almost like desert, I guess, but now it has inversed my particular piece of raster data. Now let's flip over to the other piece of raster data so you can actually see the changes. This is just black and white, but let me flip over to this one and I'll zoom in to this layer. Okay, So this is another piece of raster data, which I have done the, I believe this is the white to black, I believe. Yeah, white to black. So what it's done is taken the darkest colors, which is zero, and made them white. Okay, and taking the lightest colors, which are black, or the lightest colors, which are white, and made them black. And so you can use this however you see fit with whatever raster data that you're bringing in. That's the black to white on that. And we can always take it back to normal. Multiband color, apply. As long as there's data there to be represented, it can be represented. So what is that useful for, the white to black and the black to white? As you saw in my other raster image, I was able to inverse a white to black raster spectrum. And so what that can be useful for, let's say if you're dealing with dark colors that depict a specific object, like maybe a lake, or maybe some kind of, it could be like a river, or it could be some dark valley. And let's say you want to highlight those specific areas. Well, you can inverse it and those dark areas will become light. And so that is just a simple way to use the single band gray function. Very short, very sweet. Thank you guys for watching this video. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And as always, I will see you in the next one. Peace.